Yeah, we have seen some problems on the transformers previously. Now we are going ahead with a few more problems. So before going to that, let us see some formulas related to transformers. You know, this is the MF equation. So the ratio of E1 by E2 is equal to N1 by N2 is equal to A, or it can be written as E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1 is equal to K. So where A is called turns ratio of a transformer, where K is called transformation ratio. So K and A, there K is equal to 1 by A, you can write. You know this I0 is equal to working component square plus magnetizing component square. So we know the phi naught formula, tan inverse of I mu by W. So equivalent resistance and reactance we can calculate. It refers to primary and refers to secondary. Refers to primary, R1 plus R2 by K square, or A square into R2. So like that, R02, you can calculate R2 plus R1 into K square or R1 by K square. The same way, X value also you can calculate. So open circuit test we have seen. From the open circuit test, you can calculate R0, X0. To calculate R0, X0, we need first the wattmeter reading. From the wattmeter reading, we can calculate cos phi naught. Therefrom you can get IW, IMU. Therefrom you can get R0, X0. From the short circuit test, you can calculate equivalent reactance and the resistance. For that, we need the wattmeter reading, the current. From that, you can calculate R equivalent. Z equivalent can be obtained by VSC by IS. So this is OCSC test. Coming to the voltage regulation, there is a regulation down or regulation up. It is a regulation down generally. No load voltage minus full load voltage by no load voltage into 100 if it is in percentage, or in per unit it is not required. So we know the regulation means when a load at a particular power factor is thrown off, so then that is this voltage under full load, this is the voltage. So if it is a regulation up, we can take no load voltage minus full load voltage by load voltage into 100. It is up, it is down. So we can also write this one in terms of I2 R0 to cos theta plus or minus X0 to sin theta divided by V0 to this derivation we have seen. So from this, we can calculate the regulation for both lagging and leading power factors. For lagging it is plus, leading it is minus. So I have seen zero voltage regulation cos theta formula and maximum voltage regulation. These two have derived. So coming to the efficiency, you have seen the, you know, the efficiency formula. Maximum efficiency, iron loss equal to copper loss. Load current at maximum efficiency equal to I2M is equal to I full load into square root of iron loss by copper loss. These conditions we have seen. So KVA supplied at maximum efficiency is equal to V2 I2M cos theta by output plus 2 into iron loss. This is maximum efficiency, copper loss equal to iron loss. If it is for any load, simply you have to multiply this full load output into M. So where M is equal to iron loss by copper loss. This is the all day efficiency formula, output in kilowatt hour by input in kilowatt hour. So these are the some of the formulas on the single phase transformers. So we'll see the problems. We'll see the problems on the three phase transformers also. We have seen some problems already during the discussion. Let us have some more problems based on the theory what I have discussed. So it is a simple problem. 3300 by 250 volts 50 hertz transformer built on a core having effective cross section area given 125 centimeter square, and it has some number of turns. The turns are given as here, so 70 turns are given on the low voltage winding, that means 250 voltage side. Calculate value of the maximum flux density, number of turns on the high voltage winding. So for this, simply you write E1, E2 values. Frequency is given, cross section area A, you convert into meter square. Then we know the formula of the EMF equal to 4.44 pi f T2. Because secondary side, T2, primary side, T1 will take. So from that, the maximum flux density can be written as, from this, Because we know that phi can be written as B into A, because area of cross section is given. So that's why phi can be written as in terms of B into A. So from that you calculate the BM. All the values are given, 250 area of cross section in meters, frequency given, number of turns given. On the low voltage side, they have given number of turns. So that's why we are writing the BM. We are getting the BM value from E2 equation. So this is BM. After getting this BM, because they have asked the value of the maximum flux density, the next you have to calculate the number of turns on the high voltage winding, 3300 volts side. So simply E1 by D is equal to T1 by D2. Therefore, we can calculate. This is a basic EMF formula. From that, we can get any value, whatever you want. So you see this 125 kVA transformer having primary voltage 2000 volts at 50 hertz has 182 primary and 40 secondary turns. Okay, so they have given N1 and N2. Neglecting losses, calculate full load primary secondary currents. No load secondary induced EMF, the maximum flux in the core. This is also by directly using simple formula. You can get the first step is they are asking full load primary and secondary currents. So because they are asking currents, so they have given the voltages. You can apply this formula. KV on both sides is same. So because KVA rating for a transformer on both sides is same, that you know. So from that, because they have given KVA, 125 KVA, it is same for both the sides. So using that, applying 2000 volts on the primary, they have given the voltage. Using that, you can calculate what is the primary current. So simply V1 I1 by 1000, apply that, KVA given, therefore you can calculate I1. Once after getting I1, you can calculate I2 using this formula. Because you know I2 by I1 is equal to T1 by T2. Inversely proportional. Therefrom I2 can be obtained. So that is what they have asked, full load, primary and secondary currents. So for that, the simple thing is use KVA rating formula and calculate I1. After getting I1, get I2 using this formula. Okay, turns ratio formula. The second one is the no load secondary induced EMF. So it is a direct formula, E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1. You can get, because already E1 is known. Why? Because it is no load. Under no load condition, we know that E is equal to V. So that we have to mind, because they have clearly mentioned no load secondary induced EMF. So directly we can get, we can take 2000 volts as that E1. So we can get E2. So next third one is maximum flux in the core they are asking. So once if you know the EMF formula using either E2 or E1, any of the formulas, you can get phi m, because phi m is common for both the sides, you can get phi m value. So these problems are very basic problems they are getting from simple EMF equation, turns ratio. E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1, I1 by I2 is equal to N2 by N1, and KVA rating is same both the sides. By applying these things, we can get these basic problems solutions. So let us see this, find the active and reactive components of the no load current. They are asking IW, IMU, and the no load current of a 440 by 220 volts transformer. If the power input to the winding is 80 watts, power input to the winding is given. Low voltage winding is kept open. LV side is kept open. The power factor of the no load current is 0.3 lagging. So simply we can use the no load condition. We know P0 equal to V1 I0 cos phi naught. So from this, we know what is the active component of the no load current. IW is equal to I0 cos phi naught. So from this, P0 is given. V1 is given 440 volt. They said high voltage side is open. The single phase transformer, if the power input to the HV winding is 80 watts, HV winding power input is 80 watts, low voltage winding is open. They have given low voltage winding is open. That means high voltage side, the meters are connected. So that's why when you are using this formula, P0 and V1, because V1 is the voltage on the high voltage side. Voltage on the high voltage side and P naught is the power calculated using the wattmeter. So you just should clearly understand what is the data given, which side the meters are connected, which side the transformer is open. Using this data properly, then only you have to take these values of the voltage and wattmeter readings. So from that we got IW. Okay. So because this is IW is I naught cos phi naught, it is simply P naught by V1. We know P naught equal to V1 I naught cos phi naught. From that we got directly IW. So what is the no load current formula from this P naught by V1 cos phi naught? So you know P naught, you know V1 cos phi naught, they have given 0.3 lagging. So it is 0.606. So from these two, you can calculate the reactive component of the current. Okay. So reactive component of the no load current is nothing but square root of no load current square minus working component square. This is the reactive component of the current. So this is a simple way. Otherwise, directly you can get this I mu, I naught cos psi naught, sin phi naught formula also. From that already cos phi naught, you know. Can get sine phi naught, and you can get either this way or this way. You can calculate this way. So any other problem? A 230 by. Is it okay? Is it visible this slide? All of you. Some light is print is light. Is it visible? Somebody respond. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just go through that. There's a little light color is there. Okay. The following data refers to single phase transformer. Turns ratio given 19.5:1. R1 given, X1 given, R2 given, X2 given, and the no load current given 1.25 amperes. Leading the flux 30 degrees. Secondary delivers 200 amperes at a terminal voltage of 500 volts and power factor 0.8 lagging. Determined by the aid of vector diagram. The primary applied voltage, primary power factor, and efficiency. So previously we have seen the problem related to the no load condition. So this problem is related to the load condition. So one should have a clear idea about the load condition phasor diagram, that is UPF, as well as the lagging power factor load and the leading power factor load, etc. So first thing is what is the data they have given. First you take that. So first, should able to draw this phasor diagram. We know that this is taken as reference flux, and this is the I naught. I naught plus I2 dash equal to I1, you know this. So this is E1 equal to E2, this is minus E1. So E1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 X1 equal to V1, you know this. So this is V2. So V2, I2, they are at some angle. Depends upon the load condition given. V2 plus I2 R2 plus I2 X2 is equal to E2. So this is E2. So this phasor diagram for lagging power factor load we have seen already. So what is the data they have given? Secondary delivers 200 amperes at terminal voltage of 500 volts, 0.8 power factor. So they have given V2 value in this phasor diagram. So if you take V2 as a reference, 500 at an angle of zero, then what is the I2? It will be at some lagging angle. So that means 200 at an angle of, so this 0.8 lagging. That means cos theta plus j sin theta. If you write 0.8 minus j 0.6 lagging power factor, that's a minus. So this will be I2. Then what is the Z2 they have given already? 0.06 plus j 0.25. So from that you can calculate E2. Because we know that E2 is equal to V2 plus I2 into Z2. I2 Z2 means, so this they have given R2 plus X2. Therefore, I2 into R2 plus JX2. If you substitute, this is I2, this is Z2. So from that you got E2. So first step is from the given V2, I2 values, you calculate the E2 value. So after getting E2 value, so what is this E2? 3.5 degrees. Some voltage at an angle of 3.5. So what is this 3.5? This 3.5, you can take it as some beta if you take some angle. This angle, if you take, what is the angle with respect to V2? Because if you take V2 as a reference, this V2 is at an angle of some 3.5 degrees here. So next, what is E1 we can calculate? We know E2/E1 is equal to N2/N1. Already they have given K value. So from that you can calculate. What is K here? 1/19.5. So if you substitute here, you will get E1. So after getting E1, what is minus E1? You can calculate. So this is the value. Minus E1 means this is E1. Minus E1 means this one. So you write that minus E1 here. Next. So 1/1. We have to calculate 1/1 all the values in the phasor diagram. One must have idea about each and every calculation, because they have given first this portion. We have calculated V2, I2. Using this, we got E2. From that E2, we got E1. From that E1 got minus E1. We got this step. So after that, you can calculate I2 dash. We know what is the I2 dash. It is the additional current drawn from the primary side in order to counteract the demagnetizing effect due to load condition. So that's what we have discussed in the load phasor diagram. Okay, so I will show you once that. So in the load phasor diagram, you have seen this. So I've seen this equivalent circuit and all this. So I've seen this phi2 dash equal to phi2. I have explained you what is this phi2 dash. Okay. So to counteract this phi2, load, whenever it is connected to load, to counteract this flux, additional current will be drawn from the primary side. That will produce a flux so that this will be neutralized. Therefore, actual flux flowing will be phi. So from this, we got what is I2 dash in nothing but I2/A. Okay. So we can calculate I2 dash equal to minus I2 into K, because this is I2 dash, which is my opposite to that supplied voltage, supplied current. So minus I2 into K. Opposite to that. So you can substitute the K value and I2 value already we have. We got I2 dash. So from the figure, we know that this I2 naught is leading V2 by an angle. How much angle? This is 3.5. This is 90. This is 30. So total, this is 3.5 plus 90 plus 30. So from that, we can calculate what is I0. I0 equal to some 1.5, because we have taken V2 as a reference. We have taken V2 as a reference. Everything will calculate with respect to V2. So you can calculate I0. After getting this I0, we can go ahead with the calculation of I1. I1 is equal to this phasor sum of I2 dash plus I0. You can substitute that. We will get I1. After getting I1, you can write V2 is equal to minus E1. Plus I1 Z1. So we got this 11.5. The phase angle between V1 and I1 is given by 186.7. And so after getting this, the angle between V1 and I1 is given by, because we know already what is the angle of this I1, 141 degrees. So this is actually V1, not V2. V1 is equal to minus E1 plus I1 Z1. This is minus E1. This portion is minus E1. This is I1 Z1. That is V1. So we got already V1 value and we know I1 value. So between V1 and I1, what is the angle? The difference between these two we can take. That is the primary power factor. That means cos of 45.7 degrees. Okay. Next, what is the no load primary input power? V1 I0 cos sin phi naught. This is cos phi naught, not sin phi naught. There are some printing mistakes. So you substitute all these values. Sin phi naught, cos phi naught equal to cos 60, because already that is given. Between V1 and I0. Okay. So we will get no load primary input power. R0 refers to secondary, is R2 plus K square into R1. Same way, the total copper loss refers to secondary is equal to I2 square R02. Output V2 I2 cos phi 2. Total losses, copper loss plus core loss. Input efficiency. So if you observe this problem, if you have idea about the phasor diagram under loaded condition, and if you know what is I2 dash, what is I1, and what are these values, how to calculate these values, and that means at the secondary side, primary side, these voltage equations, one should have idea about all these values, then only they can go ahead with calculation of the required thing. They have asked determine the primary applied voltage. Okay, V1 they have asked, primary power factor they have asked, efficiency they have asked. So if you want primary applied voltage V1, you must know first V1 is equal to minus E1 plus I1 Z1. So then we have to proceed with how to calculate minus E1. It comes from again E2. So one should know how to calculate E2 first. After that, you will calculate E1. After getting E1, one should know how to calculate I1. I1 is equal to I2 naught, I2 dash plus I0. So you should have idea about how to calculate I2 dash. That means minus I2 into K. So these are step by step. So that means one value a calculation involves many things interlinked. So if you have clear idea about the phasor diagram, then you can do all these calculations. Okay. Let us see this. A single phase 100 kVA, 2000 by 200 volts, 50 hertz transformer has an impedance drop of 10%, resistance drop of 5%. Calculate regulation at full load 0.8 power factor lagging, value of the power factor at which regulation is zero. You see here, they have not given this resistance impedance values in terms of ohms. Okay. So you know the regulation formula. What is the regulation formula? I2 R02 cos phi 2 plus or minus I2 X02 sin phi 2 divided by V2 into 100. We know that. So, but here, instead of giving the values of resistance and reactance or impedance directly, they have given the drop. So for that case, we must know first how to write this drop. Then only we can proceed. So you see, they have given impedance drop of 10%. How to write the impedance drop? I2 Z02 by V2. So out of this voltage V2, what is the drop in the impedance? So if you equate that, the 10% into 100 is, that means I2 Z2 by I2 Z02 by V2 into 100 equal to 10. Then from this we will get I2 Z02 value. Same way, resistance drop they have given. I2 R02 by V2 into 100 is equal to 5. So from these two, we can calculate I2 X02, 17.32 volts. Why we have calculated all these? We know that the voltage regulation formula for lagging power factor is I2 R02 cos phi 2 plus I2 X02 sin phi by V2. So directly they have given the percentage of drop. So from the percentage of drop, you can calculate I2 R02 I2 X02 directly. And if you want even I2 R02 cos I2 R02 by V2, you can take that direct value from that instead of taking V2 separately. So you can substitute here I2 R02, you know, that is what you got 10. And I2 X02 is 17.3, you know V2. V2 is equal to, on the secondary side, 200 volts. Got it? So once if you get the secondary side 200 volts, then we'll get 9.19%. So this is the way one can get the value of this one regulation. For zero voltage regulation, directly we know the formula also, or you can substitute like this. Regulation equal to zero if you equate. So from that, tan phi t is equal to R2 by X2. Already we have derived this. Phi t is equal to square root of, phi t is equal to tan inverse R2 by R0 to X0. So we know these two drops, substitute, and you will get the power factor at zero voltage regulation. So this is the problem related to the voltage regulation. We have seen different type of problems. This is one different type. You see one more problem here. a 10 kVA single phase transformer has the reactance value, resistance value is given. Determine the approximate value of the secondary voltage at a full load 0.8 power factor. And the primary applied voltage is 2200 volts. So the question is, what is the value of the secondary voltage? Secondary voltage means V2. So the first step is, what is the data given? They have given R1 value, X1 value, R2 value, X2 value. We keep the circuit diagram in view, and they have given E1, E2 values also, the transformer rating also given. From that, you can calculate T1 by T2. I said either by calculating A or by calculating K, you will get this calculation of resistance reactance values with reference to primary or secondary. Here, we are calculating the resistance reactance values refers to secondary side. So simply R2 plus R1 into K square or 1 by A square. You will get R0 to X0. After getting R0 to X0, applying this KVA formula, so they have given the 10 KVA transformer, you will get I2. So cos phi 2 they have given. From that you can calculate, after taking the cos phi value, you will get E2 value. From that you will get V2 value. The question is V2. You have to calculate V2. What is the V2 formula? We know that E2 is equal to V2 plus I2 R0 to cos phi 0 2 plus I2 X0 to sin phi 0, sin phi 2. So for this case, what are the values required to calculate? E2 we have to calculate. To calculate E2, we must know E1. So E1 already given, T2 by T1. No? So E2 we got. So after getting E2, next we should calculate R0 to X0. So this is the one we have calculated, R0 to X0. Then next step is we should know I2. How to calculate I2? By using KVA formula. Because V2 is given. So the step is, how to calculate V2 if you know. The remaining things, how to calculate all these values, we should go ahead. That's why you should start with this. This is the beginning step. From that you calculate one by one all these values. Next, a simple problem. The transformer has 2% resistance, 5% reactance. Find its voltage regulation at full load. 0.8 power factor lagging. It is a objective type of questions. So already I told you about the per unit resistance, per unit reactance thing. Simply, per unit means I2 R0 by V2 is into 100. It is percentage of the voltage drop. I2 R0 by V2 is per unit. If there is no 100, it is per unit. If there is a 100, it is a percentage. We know the formula. I2 R0 cos phi 2 plus I2 X0 sin phi 2 divided by V2 is a voltage regulation. Simply what you have taken, I2 R0 by V2, that path is R per unit. I2 X0 by V2, that is X per unit. So they have given R per unit 0.02, that means 2% they have given, that is 0.02. X per unit is 0.05, substitute and get. So this is the way should utilize the per unit values as well as the percentage values in terms of resistance drop or reactance drop for calculation of voltage regulation. This problem, a 400 volts 50 hertz transformer has a total core loss of the transformer was found 2400 watts, and the transformer supplied 200 volts and 25 hertz, the core loss is 100 watts. Calculate the hysteresis decoupling loss. We have seen the separation of the core loss problem already during the discussion. So simply you do this thing. V1 by F1 you write first. Next V2 by F2 you calculate. Therefore V1 by F1 equal to V2 by F2. So from this separation of core loss experiment, we have seen Pi by F equal to A plus BF. You substitute Pi value, F value. We will get one equation. And then for 800 watts, again you take 800 by 5 is equal to A plus 25 B. And that means you convert in this. You simplify this. So there are two equations, and solving these two equations, because they have given 200 volts, 25 hertz transformer, core loss is 100 watts, calculate the hysteresis decoupling loss at 400 volts, 50 hertz. So same way you have to get the two equations, and calculate the two unknowns. From that, you calculate pH and pE.